Well, yeah, but this is the same as the first calendar year, Apostle. November starts the right calendar year. I gave a prophetic utterance at church, at work. I call it church, wherever I am, that's church. I said to them that 2016 will be the beginning of the greatest year in the life of Scotia. Noon target will be exceeded. And God being my witness every week since 2016's begun, sales target has increased. Why? Because the same message that the apostle gave in this house is the same message that they declare in the word. This is the year of restoration. See, I don't know how much you take this word serious. But I take what he says serious. And I walk in that apostolic anointing. That is not just the church. That is the work. That's the home. Everywhere you go, that's the same message. You see, when that embassy gets the message from headquarters, that's the same message. It's not my message. And I would that you would go wherever you go and declare a message of restoration. Minister, that's a message for the house. This is the year of restoration. This is the year of beginning of restoration for this land. Forget the politics. Yes. See the heart of God in this land. Yes. Politics have blinded our minds from what God is doing in this country. Yes. It's not by power, nor by might, but by the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God is moving all through this land. From Inaba in the south to Grand Key in the north. The Spirit of God is hovering over this land. And that is an indication that greatness will be restored. Amen. I don't care which government in power, it has nothing to do with whether God left you or not. I just want to know I'm where God wants me to be. Amen. So I'm declaring in this house that in this season, God has given the house of destiny a blank check, already signed by heaven. Whatever you desire, when you pray, you believe, you receive it, and it's yours. Whatever you desire, when you pray, if you believe, you receive. Heaven said, so let it be. Amen. I don't know what your desire is for God, but there are some great things I want to do for God.
Amen.
And I'm saying to God, God, if nobody believes your word, I believe your word. Amen. I am so crazy in my belief that if God tells me show up somewhere at a certain time, I love you. Get there by hook or by crook. Why? Because that's the place of divine encounter with God. Every time God did great things, he showed people, pull them out and say, come go with me. As I hasten and I wrap up, I'm saying to you as a church, as a house of destiny, that God wants to really establish us to do some great things in this season. We are moving in a season and in a direction that if God was to look throughout the nation of the Bahamas and said, I want to use a house to be a blessing to others, why can't it be destiny? And I'm saying to you and I, let's walk and activate the blessing of Abraham.
Amen.
That's the blessing of greatness. That's the blessing if we were to do it. God will do great things in and through our lives, and we will see that God has kept his word. When Job went through all that he went through, God said to Job, and that's what Job declared, though my beginning may be simple,
yes,
my latter end will be great.
Yeah.
I'm saying to you and I in this season that your best years are still headed. Your best yet are still ahead of you. And I believe that with every fiber of my being, I tell you. Because I believe in that in this year, that everything that the enemy stole from me. And I went back as far as I can remember. And I made it. And I said, you will not just give me back what you took. Because I'm believing that you are benefited from the use of the stuff that you stole from me. I want my stuff back with compound interest. I don't know about you, but I'm walking that kind of walk. So if you see me acting contrary, it's because God gave me a promise. If you see me doing some things that you are unfamiliar with, it's because I dare to do what God said differently. It ain't that I want to be contrary. Sister Ingram said to me this morning, she said, Reverend God, I know you long time. I know you to be different than who you are. She says to me, take the shackle off. You ought to be walking in such a different level than you are. Simply because she knows that if God tells me to do something, I will do it whatever it takes. I'm believing God that in this season, that God will do some things through me. I said to my family, that I want to be a blessing to every one of y'all and your children and your children's children. Why? Because I'm believing that God is going to bring that kind of wealth and riches through me. I told my wife that if she walk away from me, she walking away from the greatest part of her life. Why? Because I believe going forward, my greatest years yet. Why? Because I believe that she has not seen my best years yet. I believe in God, like the apostles, that I don't have to show up. My shadow alone could get it done. Say it. I'm believing God in this season. A handkerchief can bring deliverance. I'm believing God that the spoken word can bring deliverance. Because in this season, I'm convinced that ain't nothing too hard for God. God is about to do something great. Why can't he use you and I to get it done? This brother Larry in church today? Well, Larry, stand for me, Larry. They can put you on the spot like that. Well, while I was up here, the Lord tells me to tell you that even though that which you had was taken away from you, he will multiply that which you have lost to the extent that there will be nothing that you can do going forward. There is a comeback with your name on it. Jason, the Lord tell me to tell you the same thing. There's a comeback for you. There's a comeback for you. This is not the season to write anybody off. Don't write nobody off in this season. Why? Because God will raise that person up as Apostle comes, he has a word. As he comes, I'm saying to you as the people of destiny, the kind of anointing that's over this house. If we walk in that anointing and be obedient under that anointing, miracles, greatness, riches, wealth will come through you. And as the fourth will come, if you believe that this season is your season, I want you to stand here. If this is your season, say, I believe in God that this season, I want you to stand here. If this is your season, say, I believe in God that in this season, if we walk in obedience in the things that he has set forth for us to do, we can be the beginning. We can be the conduit to which greatness is restored to the house of God. I want you to say, come go with me. Come go with me. Come go with me. When the ship is taking us. God bless you.